Okay, so here we're going to do some staining on some oak boards that we just bought, getting them ready for putting in projects around the house. So we've got the mask on, got the gloves on, just using a Rig here because brushes usually need too much cleaning afterwards. This way we can just kind of spread the rag out to dry and then throw it away afterwards. So just kind of spreading it in everywhere, flipping the rag around so we can get some more of the stain. Pretty soon I'm gonna have to dip some more. Don't want to put it on too heavy here. Don't want it to sit too long either. Not gonna be a whole lot to wipe off because we're putting on pretty thin. This old board has a little bit of nice curly cues in it. Hoping to bring that out a little bit with the stain, and then later we'll have to put some polyurethane on it. Nothing too fancy. Didn't do a lot of sanding or anything. Want the unique character. Spreading it here. As you can see on either side, there's boards that I just got done staining a couple minutes before this. They'll have to sit and dry for at least a day before starting to put the polyurethane on. It's going to take several coats of polyurethane. Getting in all the grooves here. Especially that knot. Gonna have to squeeze it into the knot probably. Some smelly stuff. Keep smelling it for a good couple days after doing this. Unfortunately, it's February, so I can't do it in the garage. We're outside, so right now it's being done in the basement. There's the end of the board right there. Yeah, got some cut marks there that were a little deep. That's fine, we're looking for character. Squeeze it in the knot. Don't want any white spots where the stain didn't touch. Alright. That's looking pretty good. Oh, found another spot there. Alright, grab a almost clean rag here and get the excess wiped off so it stops soaking in. Don't want to get some splinters and slivers. That happens sometimes. A stain-filled sliver is not fun. And there we go. It's looking pretty good. Alrighty,